Welcome to my channel. My name is Kinga and I started making YouTube videos to document for myself and my friends or whoever is watching this how I am reinventing my life and my basically myself after divorce. And well, online dating has been a big part of the after divorce chapter of my life, but I think it's all for the wrong reasons, because in the beginning you just want to fill that gap and avoid feeling lonely, and later on you realize that you're not ready for something new, but you may have physical needs and you may end up on Tinder. Then you get sick and tired of the hookup culture and, you know, the meaningless conversations, and you decide to take some time off for yourself, you know, and healing. And then you may hop back on, but this time you will want something more, or something with more potentials than what Tinder can offer you. In this video, I will tell you how I personally choose my platform for finding meaningful connections, may that be friendship or more, and why I prefer online dating to just bumping into someone in real life, and how I do this sifting and sorting through the meat market based on all the little informations and hints that I can get. And I'm also going to give you all the red flags that I look out for, you know, the type of guys I would avoid and why, and I tell you how to spot them. And yeah, by the way, you know, this list is based on my personal preferences, so it doesn't have to be universally accurate or true for you. But you may also recognize some of the patterns, the type of guys I'm talking about, and I think you will agree with me on most of it. I want to clarify, before I dive deep into the subject, that I have completely changed my approach to online dating after really understanding and more consciously applying the law of attraction to basically every area of my life. What do I mean by that? Basically, I understood that if I have a high desire, a need, or a want for something, which could be a romantic relationship, I will be most likely trying to manifest it from this feeling of not having it, right? You know, because that scarcity or lack is kind of the driving force behind wanting it in the first place. And the feeling of lack is not going to draw that desired thing or person to my life, because what I have or how I feel is what I attract more of. And instead of using dating sites to look for something or someone, I decided to use them as an extra platform for the universe to, you know, led people my way who would serve as a mirror to me about where I am at right now, and to show me what kind of an energy I am emitting. And also, I'm kind of using it as a playground where all the guys I meet and talk to can help me understand even better what kind of a partner I would like to attract later on to my life. And I spoke to many people from there, you know, with the intention to help me clarify what I will want in the future. Basically, what I like, what I don't like in a man. And in this process, I have also met some really great, really cool people who I became friends with. I'm actually going to make a video on how to use online dating if you're a conscious creator and if you like to apply the law of attraction to your dating game. But in this video, I will just guide you through how to filter, or how I filter, you know, the kind of people I will be willing to invest time into getting to know. And just because you use the law of attraction and visualizing your ideal partner and, you know, becoming the energy you want to attract to yourself, you will still get a lot of irrelevant likes or flirts or messages, you know, from people who are not what you are into. They can still serve as a contrast or become your friend if the connection is there and it's real. In this video, I'm inviting you to my world of online dating and how I personally filter out people I'm interested in. I just basically take the lazy approach where I let guys initiate the first contact, you know, make the first move, or let the universe guide them to me, and then I sift and sort. I met most of my exes online, including my ex-husband, who we spent amazing 8 years together, and we are still best friends. I also made some really, really good friends through online dating sites. I mean, that may be surprising to some of you. Some of these friends I've been friends with for like over a decade now. And I also had my weekly radio show about online dating at one point in my life when I was younger. And online dating in general has added extra value to my life, you know, when it comes to like meaningful connections or just understanding men in general and myself and the whole dating. I've also seen a lot of tricks. I met a lot of weird people, interesting people, pretty cool people. Basically spoke to a lot of guys online and then offline, and I think I spent more than enough time in the jungle of online dating. Sometimes I used it because I was bored, sometimes with the true intention to find love and, you know, a perfect partner, sometimes just to make new friends. And I can tell you straight up that swiping apps are not really my style, because I tried, you know, like, don't get me wrong, but I just don't like the energy that they have, like Bumble and Tinder and you name it. They all feel like hookup sites to me. And if you find a couple of people there who are looking for something more meaningful, you know, still, there's just this weird energy about the whole platform, you know, where people are more likely to swipe further or unmatch you before they would take the time to really get to know you, and, you know, without giving you any reason. And to be honest, I kind of became that person myself as well while spending time on these apps. So it's like you don't have the patience anymore. And what I really don't like is how this is actually creeping into the real offline dating world as well. As in, people seem to or don't seem to want to take the time to truly understand and discover other people. You know, they just stop talking to you or end it before it has even started, because they just don't want to put the work into, you know, the whole thing. And they just know that there are plenty of fish out there. And that can be overwhelming, and it can cause anxiety in a lot of people. I know that. And the fact that now, you know, your options are kind of unlimited. You're not just looking at potential partners living in your village, but you have the, you know, the option to select from the whole world's population. I mean, that's just crazy. I think that's only works if you use a travel mode than Tinder, or I'm not really sure. And I know it can be liberating, but I think it makes people less committed as well and less interested in making the effort. And I just think that communication in general just feels so empty on these apps, and people don't really invest time into writing a proper bio about themselves. And sometimes it seems like it can take ages before you can actually dive deep into a proper, maybe even inspiring conversation with someone. It seems like on these apps, the majority of the people will only approach you with a hi, and then you say hi back, and then they say, how's it going? And then you say, yeah, it's going well, thank you. How's it going for you? What are you up to? What do you do for fun? What your plans are for the weekend? What do you work with? I just truly don't have the patience and the time for that. And maybe 1 out of 100 times, a guy hits me up who's really good at striking up a good conversation. He can write like, you know, whole sentences, and maybe even referring to my bio, showing that he actually read my bio. And he refuses to ask the same boring questions about my well-being and the weather. Instead, he just picks something out of the info that I have actually given on my profile about myself. And it just takes the whole communication to a different level, you know? And that's my style. I mean, that is also how I would approach someone. Starting with a question that really shows that you looked at the profile beyond the photos and you are creative enough to drop a question that would either make the person think or smile and make them want to get to know you better. And then, of course, you exchange numbers, and then you talk more, and then you meet in person. But for me, you know, finding someone who truly gets me interested was so rare on these swiping apps that I just deleted my accounts after like a very short time, to be honest. I mean, nothing wrong with these apps and nothing wrong with the hookup culture if both parties are after the same thing, but it's just not my cup of tea right now. And I will not even talk about the psychology behind the so-called collectors, who are just only using these apps to get likes, matches, and new followers to their Instagram profiles or whatever. I prefer old school, traditional online dating sites where you are required to write something about yourself and who or what you're looking for. You also have to give like basic information about you, your circumstances, instead of just, you know, throwing up a bunch of emojis up there, making the other person wonder what you were trying to say and what you did with all the characters and the time you saved by using emojis instead of typing letters. I mean, writing about myself and my ideal partner and relationship is also something that I would do regardless of am I using a dating site or not, because this is a great first step before I want to visualize and consciously create and attract the experience I want to my reality. You may wonder if I'm so picky and fussy and old school, why do I still prefer online dating to just bumping into someone in the real world? I mean, first of all, I live in Sweden, and I could tell you that during the 8 years I've been living here, I could count on one hand how many times a man looked at me with a clear appreciation of how I look, or just simply making an eye contact, let alone, you know, chatting me up. It's like a whole different game here. I also believe that the only thing that can actually arouse your interest when meeting someone in real life is the, you know, is the way the person walks and talks or looks or whatever. So basically, it comes down to physical appearance, and that can be pretty misleading. You know, it can mess with your true perception of the person. It can influence you in a way where you will be unable to pick up red flags, and you know, you can simply be blinded by his looks or his reactions towards you, and you will basically hear what you will want to hear, you know, just because you think he's so cute and you two will have amazing babies together. So instead of letting all my hormones control me, I prefer to use my mind first, or at least before my hormones take over. Because my mind is also where I store that long-ass Excel spreadsheet about all the requirements I have for a man or a relationship I would be willing to invest time into, or, you know, kind of relationship I want to attract. I feel that online dating websites provide the perfect platform for getting to know someone before actually getting to know them. To help you decide if you want to get to know them at all, you know, imagine it like a library or a bookstore where you go to your favorite section. You know, this is your first filter to narrow down the whole collection, like filtering on location or age or whatever. And from that selection, you pick up the book that talks to you first just by the cover of it, right? I mean, I'm personally very influenced by the cover art, and I actually also pick wine based on its etiquette. I know it's not a sophisticated method, but hey. So back to the books. I would not just buy the book because it has a pretty design on the front, obviously, but it would certainly get my attention, and I would then read the blurb at the back, you know, that short promotional piece describing what the book is about, and it, you know, it truly has the power to raise my interest in buying the book or not. And this is, you know, the guy's bio or profile on the dating site. It would tell you a lot, you know, have they taken the time to write up something creative, or have they skipped the whole first step, or maybe just wrote something shallow or short. And I think this part can also tell you how serious they are about the whole online dating game. Have they made the effort? And also, can they spell? Can they put whole sentences together? Do they use punctuation? I mean, you would be surprised. I don't want to sound like the grammar police, but to me, this is very, very important. And if his bio is full of typos and grammatical errors, then no matter how good looking the guy is, I just skip. I mean, you know, I can't do it. He may not be smart, or just he's super lazy or careless. And the same applies to those who just put words after each other without any punctuation, like, you know, comma or full stop. I mean, again, like, what do you do with the extra time that you saved on not using any? And there are those who actually write, "I'm not good at writing about myself, but here it goes." I'm like, what? You had like 40 plus or whatever years to figure out who the hell you are. And if you cannot write down 5 sentences about who you think you are and make it sound interesting, then what you gonna bring to the table if you started dating? Also, what kind of a self-knowledge or self-awareness do you possess? Like, I don't know, I'm just not interested. Oh, and there are those who write this very generic intro that has like basically letters and words but doesn't really say anything, you know? I also found that tons of guys use the same list of words, like, you know, if they copied and pasted it from the same source, I don't know. Maybe there's a template for guys out there, I don't know, but it goes like this. "I'm a down-to-earth, easygoing, laid-back kind of guy who likes to travel, eating out, movies and animals." I mean, like, who doesn't like to eat or travel or movies or animals? And when I read down to earth and easygoing and laid back, I'm sorry, I'm already bored. And normally these guys are the guys who write that they are looking for a woman who is nice and kind, and that's it, like, full stop. I mean, that is really sweet, but personally me, I hope to never ever get described as the nice and kind woman. I mean, this is just so boring to me. Not because these are not good characteristics to have, but because, like, come on, like, a woman or any person has so much more depth, or, I mean, at least I want a man who's looking for more than just nice and kind. Someone who wants mentally stimulating or inspiring or honest or confident or emotionally mature or whatever. I can be nice and kind, but I like to think that I'm also so much more than that. And I want a guy who wants so much more than that, because it means that they are so much more than that themselves, and they do possess a certain level of understanding who they truly are, who they think they can work well with. And if they don't know, then who the hell knows? Like, I want to meet someone who comes to the arena already knowing all that and having preferences, complex needs, and has taken the time to figure it all out. Okay, let's say that the guy has an okay profile, decent intro, and some photos. If he has only one photo or none, be suspicious, because he's either hiding or not confident or not decent looking, or just not serious about the whole thing, you know? I mean, I hear some guys saying that they work in this and that sector, or they work for the government, therefore they don't want to upload any photos, but they are willing to send them in a private message, and that's kind of okay and sometimes understandable. And there are those who are going to use photos from like 20 years ago, and they don't look like that anymore, obviously. How can you spot the old photos? I mean, well, the worst thing is when they actually scan like photo prints. And I mean, like, come on, like, you will know it's old. You know it's clearly not from the digital era. Especially if, you know, the photo print has that red or yellow time stamp on it as well. That's just ridiculous. And then there are those who actually mix their super old photos with their latest ones, obviously by mistake. And after all those magazine photos with the six packs and all, when they used to do sports or modeling, you just see an old fat dude, like, who is that? And it's not the grandpa, and it's not a mistake. It's all the same person. And I can understand that, you know, some of us love to remember the days when we looked younger and fabulous and more in shape, but, you know, just let it go and be true about representing what you look like now. There's just no point, like zero sense, you know, to show what you looked like 20 years ago. We don't care. I mean, you know, my boobs were perkier like 20 years ago, but come on, we want to see what you look like now. Oh, and my favorite stereotypes. The dude posing with the sport cars. I'm not interested. It's probably not even yours. And even if it is it truly the most important or representative thing you want to show about you and your life to a stranger? I mean, it may influence some of you ladies out there, but I would rather go for a guy who has his shit together and doesn't brag about it. And he has better ways or tools to gain attention than just, you know, by posing next to some expensive cars. But my all-time favorite is the fisherman. I wish I could include like actual photos of the actual people I mentioned here, but I don't want to get into any legal dispute or hurt anyone's feelings. So let's just use our imagination. The fisherman. I mean, like, what is going on there? Why do you guys think that the bigger the fish they pose with, the better their chances are on online dating sites? No idea. Or I don't even understand what the message is behind the fish kind of thing. Like, what is he trying to tell me? This is something I still haven't been able to figure out. I think it's also especially disturbing for us vegetarians. Oh, and be aware of the guy who wears sunglasses on all his photos. They might have some funny eyes going on. Or the one that never smiles, you know, and shows his teeth. I mean, well, you exchange numbers, you get to WhatsApp, and maybe one day you do a video call and you will not be happy. I've been there. Trust me. I also try to avoid guys who write that they want a drama-free relationship or a woman. It just means to me that they cannot deal with conflict at all. And also, what do you mean by drama-free? Like, drama can be so many things, like losing a friend to cancer or not returning a call for 5 minutes, but maybe even for days. You know, I get it. You know, there are unnecessary dramas, and we women are more sensitive and we are more emotional in general, and we can go a bit too far sometimes, and we can bring in unnecessary stress to relationships. But just, you know, putting it out there that you want a drama-free relationship is kind of like a warning sign for me, you know, saying that you're not ready or willing or able to stand up if shit hits the fan, and you definitely don't want any conflict or maybe not good at handling conflicts at all. And I may be wrong, but this is just, you know, my take on drama-free requirements. If a man takes the time to send me a message, but all it says is, "Hi, gorgeous," or "Hello, pretty," or "How you doing?" I just don't respond. I mean, first of all, it was not addressed to me personally. It's just a copy and paste chat up line that you can send out basically to hundreds of other people. It definitely shows that you only wrote because you checked my photos, but you definitely haven't taken the time to read my bio, which makes me question your intentions, your needs, and the depth to your personality. I just know that we wouldn't match, so, you know, just I just wouldn't respond. I mean, my profile is so detailed and so to the point, and okay, it's kind of like long as well, and I know it intimidates some men, and it also turns off others just by the length of it, which is all cool. I mean, you know, less junk emails for me to read, but still, you know, if I took the time to write it and you're really interested in me, you're gonna take the time to read it. I like to use my profile as a first filter, you know, like, are you interested in me to read it? Did you like it? Can you pick out something that you want to know more about? Are you creative enough to start a conversation based on the endless amount of information I gave? I mean, the real quality men do stand out to me so easily and by far just by their first message. It will feel personally addressed to me. And, you know, the way they would express themselves in writing, I mean, just every little detail about it would already tell me a lot about them. And even if I don't like their profiles or photos, but they have taken the time to express that they read my profile and they would be interested in learning more about me, I will still reply and I will definitely say thank you for all the compliments they included, and I will find a way to kindly tell them that I'm not interested. I mean, after all, it must be pretty hard sometimes, you know, for guys to take the courage to make the first move, knowing that they may have to handle rejection. So I do show my appreciation to those who approach me in a kind and intelligent way, even if I don't feel attracted to them. I also get messages that are straight up marriage proposals. Like, they are well written and kind and nice, but also straight to the point. And I mean, this is something that we have to address here, ladies. Please don't fall for them. You're probably pretty and smart and have a great profile and would love a committed man who would one day propose to you, but guys like that are just too desperate to get married to almost anyone, it seems, because they definitely don't know you yet. So if they approach you already talking about marriage, run! These are all my red flags that I can think of right now. I mean, there are plenty of others, to be honest with you. But I hope I was able to provide some useful information to my fellow women out there who's trying online dating sites, and hopefully even to some men out there who are about to step on the meat market, wanting to stand out and approach women with a higher chance of getting a reply back. Hit me with your questions or personal online dating stories in the comment section. And if you are a conscious creator who operates with the law of attraction and you want to know how to use online dating in a different way, or how to combine online dating and the law of attraction, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell sign so you will get notified when my video is up. I really hope to keep in touch. Take care. If you want a more intimate content and daily communication, please go and join my Facebook group called Kinga Kremer and Friends.